Hey, I'm Joe with Inch Calculator. Today we're going to talk about how to add or subtract feet and inches. If you're here, there's a good chance you're wondering how to do that. So we'll go over three different ways to add or subtract measurements with feet and inches. Before we begin, we should cover some ground rules that we need to know when we're working with feet and inches. First, there are 12 inches in a foot, which is important to keep in mind. More on this later. We also need to cover how we know what the feet and inches are in a measurement. As we look at a measurement like this, we can see that each number is denoted with the letters FT or IN. These are feet and inches, respectively. Sometimes feet and inches are marked with an apostrophe or quotation mark like this. These symbols are technically known as a prime or double prime. Okay, so now that we've covered what the feet and inches are in a measurement, let's talk about the first method for adding feet and inches. Let's start with adding 5 feet 3 inches with 3 feet 2 inches. To add them together, start by adding the inch measurements. Then add the feet measurements. As you can see, the result is 8 feet, 5 inches. All right, let's try a slightly more challenging example and add 4 feet 8 inches with 2 feet 7 inches. Just like before, let's add the inch measurements together. As you can see, 8 plus 7 is 15 inches. Then we'll add the feet measurements together. 4 plus 2 is 6 feet. But remember earlier when I mentioned there are only 12 inches in a foot? A resulting measurement with 15 inches can be simplified a bit, since 15 inches is larger than 1 foot. To simplify, subtract 12 inches from 15 inches, since there are 12 inches in a foot. Then we'll add that additional foot to the feet column. So the result here is 7 feet, 3 inches. Okay, so that covers addition, but what about subtraction? We can subtract measurements like these in just the same way we added them. Let's take a look. Let's go through how to subtract 3 feet 2 inches from 5 feet 3 inches. Just like with addition, start by subtracting the inches first. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1 inch. Then we can subtract the feet measurements. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2 feet. So the result here is 2 feet 1 inch. Okay, let's try something slightly more challenging and subtract 2 feet 7 inches from 4 feet 3 inches. Again, let's start by subtracting the inches. 3 minus 7 is negative 4. But we need a result greater than 1, so we need to do something to fix this. If you recall, there are 12 inches in a foot, so the way to handle this is to subtract 1 foot from the feet measurements and add 12 inches back again into the inches, like this. So now, let's try solving the inches portion of this equation again. 3 minus 7 plus 12 is equal to 8 inches. And finally, let's solve the feet portion. 4 minus 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 foot. So the result for this is 1 foot, 8 inches. If you found that helpful, we'd love it if you could like this video to help others find it. And if you want to learn more, we actually have a detailed guide that goes through this in much more depth and has a ton of examples. I'll add a link to that in the description below. I did promise 3 methods to add feet and inches together, so let's go through the second method. Since we know there are 12 inches in a foot, what if we converted each measurement to inches first, so there was only a single number to represent each measurement that we can add together? Let's go through an example of how we might do this, starting with the original addition problem. Let's rewrite the problem a bit to convert each foot measurement to inches first by multiplying each by 12. Then we'll solve it, starting with the conversion to inches. So now the problem looks a little more like a standard addition problem, and we can simply add 63 inches plus 38 inches, which is 101 inches. We actually have a pretty cool feet to inches conversion calculator. I'll link in the description below if you're interested in that. Okay, you've made it this far, so now let's cover the final and easiest way yet to add feet and inches. The final way to add measurements is to head on over to inchcalculator.com and use our feet and inches calculator. It's a shameless plug, I know. The calculator is actually pretty cool though. Just enter your equation and get your results. I'll add a link to this calculator to the description below, so if you're interested, feel free to check it out. And that's it, 3 easy ways to add feet and inches. We hope this helped you out. If it did, please like this video, which helps us out a ton.